anyone else call?
You asked that before. I was out a lot of the time in the works. I locked the cabinet every time I left my office.
Right. Please don't leave town until this matter has been squared up. You're an important witness and I might need you again.
What's going to happen about me for taking the dynamite from the quarry?
We'll talk about that later. I won't forget the straightforward way you have helped me. Bugler was still uneasy.
Scriboma will kill me when he gets to know what I've told you. You forced me to say some very unpleasant things about Bert.
I forced you to do nothing. I didn't even caution you. You simply decided to cooperate with the police because that's the right thing to do. Leave it at that. It will serve you in good stead. Meanwhile, not a word to Scriboma about this interview or what you have said about his part in the bank attempt.
He knows I'm here. He's sure to ask.
Simply tell him, then. We have been questioning you closely about the finances and other business of Excelsior. That's all.
Bugler left with melodramatic gestures of caution and care, as though his brother-in-law might have been listening behind the door and waiting for a chance to dispatch him without more ado.
Little John was glad to see the last of Bugler. He'd received a report from Cromwell about the surfeit of suspects which he'd accumulated at the Rose Alba quarries. Now, Little John was getting his share. He needed time to think. He also needed a bit of peace and quiet, for the loudmouth amplifier was under the windows again.
We need a change! Vote for Moody this time!
Chapter 14. Directors' Meeting.